Great to have you with us, and first this hour, all eyes will be on the immigration minister today as he considers whether to cancel the visa of Novak Djokovic for a second time. Today's Isabella Staszkowski leads us off from Melbourne Park. Isa, good morning to you. Officials are now investigating if Novak lied on his travel forms.
Alex, good morning. Another day and yet more controversy surrounds the world number one. He essentially now has two major problems. And the first, the latest, is really around his border permit entry form. It's understood from court documents that was filled out by Tennis Australia and his agent. And in those documents, it says that he didn't travel for the 14 days prior to arriving in Australia. But it has since been revealed that he did go to Spain in late December and in early January. The second major issue, of course, lies in the hands of Immigration Minister Alex Hawke, who is still considering whether or not to re-cancel Novak Djokovic's visa. If that was to occur, he could be banned from Australia for 3 years' time, and it's possible for him to then reappeal that yet again. Immigration experts right around the world have this morning been weighing in.
I would be encouraging the minister to sit down with Mr. Djokovic, with the minister's health advisers. By cancelling Mr. Djokovic's visa, this problem just continues on and on and on.
Yep.
And Alex, we know the world is watching. Support is growing from Serbian communities and Balkan communities as well. And tennis stars are now weighing in also. We've heard from Nick Kyrgios, who says that he's embarrassed at how the world number one has been treated, while Andy Murray has said there are questions still to be answered around isolation. So essentially looking at the days after that positive result in December. Novak Djokovic himself, well, he is continuing to train here in Melbourne, seemingly undeterred and focus on the Australian Open. So a lot of different elements there, Alex, and still a lot to play out before it all begins next week.
Thank you so much. Isa, thank you.
Well, Australia's supply crisis is escalating this morning. Supermarket shelves stripped bare while Coles moves to introduce even more purchasing limits. Let's bring in Nine Federal politics reporter Rachel Baxter, who's following this story in Canberra for us. Rachel, good morning. The PM is in crisis talks.
Good morning again, Sarah. Yes, Scott Morrison is talking with industry leaders and ministers to decide who should be allowed to stay on the job, even if they're close contacts to COVID cases. This will likely include transport workers, childcare workers and people in waste management to try and battle some of those workforce shortages. CEO of independent food distributors Richard Forbes told Today on Nine, states and territories need to get behind the changes when National Cabinet meets tomorrow.
We need to get those workers right across the supply chain, from farmers to suppliers, manufacturers and distributors. We need to keep them at work because they are the ones providing food to the broad community, but also into those institutional facilities.
Major supermarkets are also taking matters into their own hands. Coles has introduced new buying limits. You can now only get two packets of paracetamol or aspirin and one packet of toilet paper per shopping trip. Sarah, some serious flashbacks to those loo paper shortages in 2020.
Here we go again. Thank you, Rachel.
The New South Wales government plans to utilise rapid tests under a new plan as cases look set to surge. Today's Gabrielle Boyle joins us from Sydney. Gabby, how can we get our hands on a rapid test?
Well, the New South Wales Premier is very keen to implement a plan, a strategy to get life back to normal as quickly as possible, particularly in workplaces and schools. And that's why he's released some ideas about how rapid tests could be sent out to the community as quickly and easily as possible. One suggested strategy is that we'd be using the Services New South Wales app in the same way that we did with our Dine and Discover vouchers, allowing us to get free rapid tests to get back to life as quickly as possible. We're also being told that parents and teachers could be given access to free rapid tests at schools to make sure that our kids are back in the classroom as quickly and as easily as possible. Christine?
Thanks, Gabby.
Let's go to the Gold Coast now, where there's significant demand at a testing clinic in Southport. The health system is expected to come under the most pressure in the first week of February. Look at those lines of cars. Wow. When authorities predict a short, sharp peak. Despite this, the chief health officer is calling for calm. Breaking news this hour, a 13-year-old boy has died after being stabbed on the New South Wales Central Coast. He was found by police with wounds to his stomach west of Gosford late last night. He was then flown to hospital in a critical condition but passed away. Another 13-year-old boy has been arrested. No charges have yet been laid. Thousands of people have been evacuated from southwest WA after a fire threatened lives and homes. Nine's Lucy McLeod is there for us this morning. Lucy, good morning to you. The fire is now contained.
It is, Alex. It's stationary at the moment and contained but not controlled, which means it could flare up at any point. So the road here, the only one in and out, is still closed, but still a significant change from what we've seen the past couple of days. At its peak, 150 firefighters were on ground battling this blaze up against steep terrain and winds of up to 50 kilometres an hour, pushing these flames metres from homes. Thousands were evacuated, some leaving with just the clothes on their back. But thankfully, overnight, crews were able to contain the blaze, making those containment lines around it so it did not spread. Thankfully, no homes have been taken. The exact cause of this blaze isn't known yet, but the arson squad will move in today and assess the ignition point as it's safe.
Okay, a beautiful part of the world down there and a lot of people still on holidays. Hey, Lucy, thank you.
Well, checking sport now, an unseeded Australian, Thanasi Kokkinakis, is thriving at the Adelaide International, upsetting world number 47, Benoit Paire, 6-4, 6-love. The hometown hero says he's playing some of his best tennis after a difficult 2021 season.
Yeah, I definitely did a lot of grinding last year, and I think that all set me up for the results I've started the year with, you know. So coming from nothing with my ranking, I had to kind of go through the grind a little bit, and I'm still there. But hopefully more tour wins will rack up, and hopefully I can keep playing good tennis.
Hopefully you can, heading into the Open, but it is weather time now. Here's Sherry.
Thanks, Chris. Well, we're at Sea Life Sydney Aquarium this morning. It's breakfast time, and coming up, we're going to be feeding Pig the dugong. He's very, very cute, but I'll introduce you to him coming up very soon. First, let's take a look at what the weather is doing in Cairns. There are a few showers around today, 31 degrees. Brisbane, a possible sprinkling, a top of 28. Much the same for the Gold Coast. Sydney, also a possible shower today, 27 degrees. A chance of a storm for Canberra, 25 the top. Mostly sunny day in Melbourne with a top of 31 degrees. Hobart, cloudy and 20. A pretty muggy day for Adelaide, 37 degrees, a hot 36 in Perth. Alice Springs mostly sunny, 41, and a possible storm in Darwin, a top of 33 degrees. Now, I have Dana Plater here, who is the dugong keeper. Dana, he's a very special boy, though, because he's the only male in human care.
Yes, that's correct. So
in the world.
In the world. He is very special here to us keepers at Sea Life Sydney Aquarium. So Pig is 23 years old. He's about 300 kilos, and you might be able to see Emily hand-feeding him some cos lettuce at the moment.
Oh, he's
very cute.
This
is quite a special opportunity for him. We normally feed him every 15 minutes throughout the day, and he'll consume at least 30 kilos of cos lettuce in one day.
Oh, my God, I've seen a lot of cos lettuce this morning. Is there something special about it?
So the cos lettuce is the closest replica we can find to his natural food source, which is seagrass. So unfortunately, seagrass is critically endangered in the world, and therefore it is actually a protected species. So he eats cos lettuce.
Oh, well, he's very, very cute. Also known, guys, as sea mermaids. You know, back in the day, they used to think he was a mermaid because of his beautiful tail. And, you know, that means I'm in good company, you know, from one mermaid to the other. And I'm glad you never found that.
Yeah, we still haven't found those pictures, Sherry. We need to dig them up. We're on the hunt for Sherry the mermaid.
Oh, leave it with us.
We'll have it before your next weather.
But that one there, that's a very attractive mermaid.
Yeah,
please don't.
Absolutely.
Thanks so much, Sherry Lee. Well done.